Hey there, welcome to Roast. This is going to be a short introduction video on how you can quickly get started. Let's dive right in. So as soon as you log into Roast, you land onto a dashboard, which is where you can create a new folder, invite other members of your team, and also create a new spreadsheet. Let's start there. With Roast, you get these slick looking table, which are grouped inside pages. You can even add new tables, and this just makes it a lot more convenient for you to interact with data from across multiple tables. You can also bring in your existing spreadsheet functions like equal sum, VLOOKUP, index match, etc. We also have a format bar right here, an insert menu to which you can add a new table, form, chart, a bunch of different action elements for you to play around with as well. Now, say we wanted to create a website traffic analysis report using our Google Analytics integration. So to start with, I'm going to add a date range. In cell B1, I'm going to go ahead and click Insert, Date Picker, and then a date range. Let's go ahead and expand this column a little bit. In cell C1, you can click on our actions component, search for Google Analytics report, and land on our custom analytics Google function right here. As for the ID, I'm just going to go ahead and paste that. For the date range, I'm going to reference that to cell B1. Let's also go ahead and add an actual date range here, which I'm going to set that starting at April 1st all the way to June 16th. In terms of the metrics, let's go with sessions as well as page views. You also have the option to play around with these optional parameters. So let's say we want to break this data down as per week. So I'm going to set the dimensions to be year week here. And once good, you can then click on the add function in C1 option right there. Once the function is executed, you can then click on this yellow icon, click on view data, navigate to all data, and quickly reference the output of the integration function. So what we'd need is right inside rows, which is the year, week, sessions, and page views. Say we wanted to access a specific data point from here, all you'd need to do is hover over that, click copy, go to the next available empty cell, and then just paste that information. Typically, what you'd end up needing is the data settled in rows and columns. And for that, you can once again click on this yellow icon, click on Create Data Table, select the different table headers. In our case, we'd need the year, week, sessions, and page views. In terms of the table destination, I'm going to select that to be the cell A1 of our table 2. Once good, you can then click on the Create Data Table option, and you'll see that the data would just instantly flow here. Let's go ahead and rename these tables as well. I'm going to name this log. I'm going to rename table 1 to input. And as for page 1, I'm going to rename that to report and the spreadsheet itself as intro. Now, these headers aren't necessarily easy to read. And to remedy that, you can once again click on this yellow icon, click on edit data table, navigate to source, and then click on rename source headers. I'm going to quickly go ahead and search for the parameters and rename them like so. Let's do that for sessions as well. And finally, I'm going to do that for week. Once good, you can then click on the rename option right there. And finally, on the update data table option from right there. Next, you might want to create a chart to visualize the data on your log. And to do that, you can select these columns, click on the insert option right here, and then on chart. You'd see the chart editor is open. We have a whole bunch of different chart types that you can use. For now, I'm going to stick to the line option right there. You can play around with the series data right here. And we have a bunch of different options that you can control the chart with under the More Options tab as well. For now, I'm going to go ahead and rename this chart to Analysis and close the chart editor. Let's also go ahead and reorganize this so that the analysis right on top of the log. Naturally, you might want to collaborate on this report with a bunch of other members of your team. And to do that, you can invite them to this spreadsheet by using this option right here. By default, you'd have the option to invite them as guests. However, you can toggle this option right here in case you'd want to invite them to the entire workspace. You have the option to invite them either as editor, through which they can even change the formulas inside your spreadsheet, or even as live users where they'd only be able to access the live mode. And if you're wondering what that is, let's quickly take a look at our live mode as well, which is what you can access by toggling this option right here. This is typically the mode that you choose in case you'd like to share this report with a bunch of other stakeholders or even publicly with the rest of the world. As you can see, all the other data points here are locked, and the only toggleable data point here is the date range. So if you were to go ahead and change this, let's say I'm going to start that from January all the way till June 16th, you'd see that the function gets executed, the chart is changed, and also the log is now updated automatically. This would look amazing on your mobile, tablet, and a bunch of other devices as well. Let's switch back to the editor and also look at a bunch of sharing options that we have. You'd have the option to share this particular report privately, which is to say you'd get a unique link, and anybody who has the access to the link would be able to access the live mode only. Or you can even share this with the rest of the world in case you're pretty proud of something that you've built and you think a bunch of other members from the community can also benefit from that. Next, let's look at our top bar, which is where you can find all the different components inside Rose. So you have the integrations here, which is essentially where you'd find a repository of all the services that we have a built-in integration with. And majority of these integrations are accompanied by a bunch of different templates that you can access from this option right here. These are essentially the pre-made workflows that we've built, ranging from a whole bunch of different use cases split across a bunch of different categories across the board. And finally, we have the community page, which is essentially where, should you choose to share a spreadsheet with the rest of the world, would show up right here. And here's where you can explore, like if in case you'd like a particular spreadsheet, you can always just click on it and you'd have the ability to duplicate this to your own workspace. I'm going to go ahead and click on duplicate once again, click on the demo link right here. And here's where you can find the spreadsheet we just duplicated. There are a bunch of different ways in which you can use rows. So for instance, this is one of the examples, which is simply a list of 50 fastest growing startups in Portugal. In case, let's say you have created an amazing calculator, this is an example of that. Say if you want to change the data here, I'm going to quickly toggle that to 50,000. You'll see that a whole bunch of other data points on the spreadsheet changed as well. And this is an example of an investor dashboard that we've created for a bunch of different stakeholders. And Rose really just elevates the way you share some of these reports and build some of these tools. Let's go back to our dashboard right here. I hope this video helped, and thanks for watching.